What's up, everybody? In today's video, we're doing something completely different, something we've really never done before on the channel. We're making a video for another game. Now, that's not new, but this is not a sponsored video. This is simply a game that came across my radar. I played for a few hours last night and was like, oh, this is that game. This game is so much fun. It looks so cool. It's currently in a soft launch in certain countries, but of course, you know, we got to work around for that, you know. Us mobile boys have been around the block. We know how to get around those things so everyone can get it. We'll do a video on that eventually. But in this video, I just want to introduce you to the game. So this is called Warcraft Rumble. It might be the best game of 2023 if it comes out in 2023. So here we are, and of course, Warcraft Rumble, it's World of Warcraft, right? So World of Warcraft characters in like a tower defense kind of game. If you want it right off the bat, it's available in Canada, Denmark, Finland, Sweden, Philippines, and Australia. Simply go to your app store and you can download it there. The rumored global release is gonna be in November 2023. In another video, if we get enough people who want to know how to download it, say if they're in the States, then we'll make a video showing how to kind of, you know, jimmy your iOS device so that it thinks you're in Canada, Denmark, Finland, all those places. But that's a different video. In this one, I just want to play the game because the game is literally that good. So we're just going to go into the very, very first level, and then we'll go into a harder level and kind of show the kind of different things that pop up. So the idea here is you're playing with like mini figurines. And with these mini figurines, there's like a game board kind of thing, and you're going through it, but it's all action, all strategy. It's pretty intense too. I have the screens cut off, so that bottom right screen is actually just gonna, you're gonna see it when we get into a match. It's gonna show the characters that I have at my disposal. So here we go. This is gonna be Goldtooth. Of course, if you play World of Warcraft, you guys know Goldtooth. You know Goldtooth. All right, so we're gonna start to fight. And then you see we got a bunch of these different characters. And our goal is to take out the boss at the end. So I'm gonna summon my fire elemental. I call this my snaky boy. And now I need somebody who can actually take out ranged characters because both of those are on the ground. Me, the characters, looks like that other guy is as well. So let's bring Jaina in. And you know, we're not gonna do much strategy in this video, but I'll tell you right now, don't pick Jaina as your starting character. Do yourself a favor. Instead, pick Bane or Kane Bloodhoof. I said Bane. So once we take out that turret, then it actually becomes ours and we can start spawning our characters from there. And as you see, we kind of made a bloodline for Goldtooth here. This was a very, very simple map, right? It was basically get to him and do your thing. There's also some spells we can throw out. Like I just threw Blizzard on the boss. I can throw Blizzard on any characters. If there's a big group of them, slow them down, take them out, all that kind of thing. One thing I love about this game is you can play it as much as you want. So like I beat this level, right? And on most mobile games, you have like an energy. And once you're done with that energy, you're done with the game for the day. To my knowledge, that doesn't exist here because I can just spam this level and level up my action guys to my heart's content. Whatever time I want to put in is what I can benefit from it. So let's go do a harder map. Let's go do, you know, let's go do Stranglethorn. We'll take on, oh, this one's so hard. Baron, I fought this guy a long, long time. So, okay, so we're now in Stranglethorn Vale. We're going to fight the boss here. And you're going to see there's a lot more going on. And I'll just, before we actually start the fight, I'll go and show all the different places. So these arrows, this is which way your characters go. So when I'm actually in a match, if I were to click that, it'll turn the arrow to the left. And then my characters will go that way as opposed to up the middle. This is a gold mine here, gold vein, I guess. And what we want to do is we want to send our kobold units over there. And they will farm that gold. And that's what we're using to summon our characters in, which is pretty cool. The crossbows, you kind of saw that already. There's also tower ones. We'll go do PvP when we're done this one. Probably done losing this one. And there's chests as well, but there's no chest here. So our main bad guy is going to be up here. No, not him. I guess they're two for one there. Anyway, so we need to get over there and take both of them out. So let's go and do this. And let's get our sneaky boy up. And you know what? I'll summon some chickens in there too. I need to eventually send chickens at him because chickens, oddly enough, are kind of like a really strong counter to that guy because he throws this giant cannon. So yeah, the bosses have different mechanics. Obviously, all the different creatures have different mechanics. So there's a lot going on. It's really, really cool. Oh, my Jaina actually reduces the cost of Blizzard once I summon her. Let's just go ahead and do that. All right, chickens come next. Let's get that ready. See, the blizzard did a lot of damage, but I'll throw my chickens over there. And so his cannonball destroys me. Oh, I didn't pay attention that the raptors were coming. But the raptors did get beaten by the chickens. The chickens go do their thing. Perfect. We summon this crossbow. So now that I actually took over this crossbow, I can start summoning off that crossbow. Now, I will also say this is a replay of this mission. So when you do this mission for the first time, it's actually much, much harder, which I thought was kind of cool. And if you saw me do it on stream, you got to check out Twitch. You can see the VOD. I was doing this match for like an hour. I didn't improve much since then. So the replay is a little bit easier than the first time, which is kind of cool, I guess. All right, before we jump into PvP, which is a really cool thing, and we got to talk a lot about how PvP works in mobile games if you're new to mobile games. Let's look at like the shops and stuff so you can kind of see what to expect if you're new to mobile games. Okay, so this is where we're buying our action figures from. Once we unlock them, to my knowledge, we don't have to spend any money to like further improve them to their maximum potential. Obviously, if we spend money, it's going to be a lot faster. But these gold coins, I'm getting these gold coins for every single campaign mission I beat. I have to assume that those gold coins also are generated through another source, because if there's a limit on the amount of gold that's in the campaign nodes and we can't unlock every character, then the game gets branded pay to win only or pay to play and the game dies. So I don't think that'll be the case. It is in open soft launch, whatever. So obviously they got tinkered around with stuff still. But you see, I got 110. So if I want to unlock one of these characters, I can go ahead and do that. I can see the info, kind of see what they do. So we know the Abomination, he does AoE cleave damage, which is really cool. And he also pulls somebody in from ranged. This guy was a huge headache in one of the matches where I just recently got through. So I could unlock him if I want to. I don't really want to. I'm kind of saving my coins in case something really cool pops up. And then we have the limited time offers. These are things very normal in mobile games as well, where you hit certain milestones in the game and then it's a limited time offer. I bought one, it was $2, because I was like, oh, I played the game for 4 hours. Show a little support, I bought the $2 one. I could see myself maybe buying a $6 offer here, probably not the $24, because the $24 offer kind of just looks like it's to increase the speed at which your characters get better, but you can just play to do that. So I will just play to do that myself. Then the bronze package, there's a bunch of different Hogger characters in there. That's pretty tempting, but I'll pass on that for now. We get free bonus XP every once in a while. So that's just going to be XP on one of our characters. You see this time it chose to do it on my Blizzard. That's cool. I love using Blizzard. So there's that. I could use my coins to buy upgrade stuff as well. Who it'll go on, I actually don't know. I'm not going to buy one of those. I'd rather save my coins for characters. And then, of course, we can buy coins. Now, this is the mobile premium currency. If you played any kind of mobile game, like if you're on my channel because you're a Marvel Strike Force player, then you know exactly this is your cores, right? The prices look outrageous. It's because they are, but that's also the mobile industry standard, so it is what it is. All right, with all that out of the way, the store, let's look at our actual character. So like I said, I chose Jaina off the bat. It forced me to put upgrades on her that I didn't want to. You can choose Kane Bloodhoof, way better. Huge tank, takes hits like a champ, doesn't suck like Jaina does. At least I don't know if Jaina scales. Maybe she scales. Maybe I chose the Bulbasaur of the Warcraft Rumble game, who knows. But this is like your deck, almost. Like these are the action figures that I can place on the board. So I have these six. If I want to trade them out, all I got to do is click on that, hit swap, and I could pick one of them that I have on the bottom part of the screen here. So the one I bought for $2 was actually this one, the Shadow Song. So I'll throw her in. Who did I throw her in over? Oh, yeah, that's fine. I threw her over those guys. Okay, that's fine. All right, cool. After that, there's the guild option over on the far right, if we're looking at the bottom right here. I started my own guild, of course. You know, we have to do it for the Dorky Dad community. If you decide to play this game, hit me up in my Discord and we'll put you in. We're allowed up to 15 members. Right now it's just me, but I already have 4 people that have messaged me saying like, I'm getting this game and I want to play with you, because they saw it on stream and it's so fun. This is going to be like your guild war chest. So depending on, I guess, the performance of your guild in certain modes, it gets higher and then you get more rewards. Pretty standard for a mobile game, right? Let's head on over to this section. I haven't unlocked dungeons yet. Unlock that in 10 gems and that'll probably make its own video, because I think I'm gonna start a channel for this video game. I love this game, it's so fun. It seems very free-to-play friendly until you get to PvP. This is kind of the thing, right? I had PvP matches where it's like I was dominating, and then I had PvP matches where I was clearly being dominated, and it wasn't close. It was like, oh, is this person getting five times the amount of gem resources that I am? So anyway, let's go in here. We'll see what we hit here, because the PvP matchup is kind of static for right now. I guess they're going through seasons, which is pretty cool. So this would be a PvP match. This is the... There's a lot going on here. We have the chest over here. I want to get the chest right away. So I'll send my kobold over there. And then I kind of want to see what my opponent's going to do. Okay. I think this guy's a spender. I think he's a spender because of that thing that would just spawn. That damn golem absolutely destroys. You can see he's taking no damage. He's doing all damage. Yeah. Yep. I think so. Oh, just absolutely rolled. I'm getting rolled. All right, we saved that, kind of. He's got some other, presumably, giant unit heading over here. Let's see how strong it is. Okay, no, it's weak. It's weak enough. Okay. So now we're going to kind of reestablish things here. I want to send a kobold up there to get those gold mines. All right, and we got to hit that arrow to make sure he goes over there. I'll send a Shadow Song here. I'll send chickens to help out. Okay, so now we're getting a gold mine. We're kind of letting him lead the dance here. He summoned a dragon. Bro, what is this character? So, is this game pay to win? Probably, right? Like most mobile games are. It's probably very much pay to win. But we'll see. I'm having fun with it regardless, so I guess it's fine. Oh, we took the dragon out. Dope, dope, dope. Our kobold's getting us gold over there. That's dope, 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 too. Okay, but we lost our base. We're gonna try and reestablish that. Oh, no, no, no. We didn't get it fast enough. Those units are just destroying us. Oh, and then they got the rocket tower. That's not good. And another dragon. Oh, that's not good. Oh, he's got a chest. They're going to steal his chest. So see, he's got a chest up there. I have a rocket person I can send over there. And I stole the gems for it. Perfect, perfect. Let's send our kobold up top. He's going to get those gems in there. And that's it. Let's go on the offensive. Oh, I summoned it too soon. I didn't wait till this one right here was done. Oh, no, no, no. All right, let's summon this. And let's summon our birds on this guy. Yes, birdies. Get him, my birdies. Yo, the birds are OP. They're actually... It's so funny how good these birds are. The damn chickens. The damn chickens are so good. I was playing this game a lot today and having just fun the entire time, which is why I'm suggesting it, that people at least give it a try. Well, look, we actually... Wow, letting him lead, we're actually doing really good here. And we've actually... Well, we've actually established a little bit of a lead here. Let's try and make sure we can keep this section for us. Oh, that was bad. I didn't hit the units. But our blizzard did. Let's go. So we're kind of using our spells to our advantage right now. And we've isolated his option to get into the gold, which is why I went to the left side. So if he can't get to the gold, we're more likely to... Okay, well, that dragon's going to wreck our day here, isn't he? We need somebody with a little bit of range. That's going to be... Jaina can get it done. So can Shadow Song, but I think the... Oh, he's got two big boys. Oh my god, the dragon destroyed it. The dragon destroyed me. Okay, the chickens will get that done. You see, like, we're getting ahead on gold and everything, but we're still getting a wreck. I think this is the spender strategy difference, which, if we do cover this game, is going to be something I will strive to always maintain, is just how to win as a light to moderate spender kind of thing. All right, our fire boy is really good at taking out ground units. There we go. Let's get some chickens in there. I think our friend here is going to get a huge advantage in the last minute, though, because that is like a... you generate twice as much gold in that time. 30 seconds remaining. Okay, yeah, so... Oh, but we're doing good. We're doing real good here. Kobold. We already have a kobold there. Let's get Jaina out here. I don't know how this works. If we just need to do damage, we're just going to do a little bit of damage to him. I don't know how it works when they run out of time. So now is a fantastic time to find out. Boom! See? Rocked it. Oh, we just take damage the whole time. Okay, wait. Oh, we won. We won. We outlasted him. We outsmarted him. Not to say anything about it, baby. He's very new to the game as well. It seemed like his units were way better than us, but we got the dub, And this is why I love this game. I'm super excited about this game. I've raged the most in the last month playing this game. I've been the most excited playing this game. And more than ever, after this, after recording and it just magically happening, I feel more than ever that I'm making the right call by making a channel to this game. Haven't done it yet. We'll be doing it. I'll follow up with that later. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you like, share, and subscribe. Let me know how you feel about the game. And if you want me to do that tutorial on how to download the game if you are in the States or one of the non-soft launch regions. Have a great day, everybody. That's it for the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you like, share, and subscribe. Stay happy, healthy, have fun, and I'll see you in the next one.